makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Are you doing this as Kermit?
No.
OK, we've cleared that up.
Jason, it's all right. Carry on.
Sorry.
Carry on.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Like a boat out of the blue, it steps in to see.
What is that noise?
When you wish upon a star, as dreamers do.
Here we go.
This is only the beginning.
He's quite boring, though, isn't he?
No, he's mental.
Come on, Max. Come on. So.
No, maybe I'm being cute, but boring.
No, that's David's dog. David's dog literally smokes a pipe, I reckon.
Yeah.
They're all ready for you. Let's
good boy, Max.
Thank you.
It's a Yorkshire Terrier.
Didn't like me, did he? What's his problem?
Hi, what's your name?
Dave.
Dave, and who have you got in your arms, Dave?
Max the dog.
He's eyeballing me, isn't he? Yeah.
Do you have a day job?
I'm getting a van driving job in 2 weeks' time.
Did you ever see Pudsey, who won the show?
Absolutely, Simon,
I mean,
yes.
Are you and Max as good as that?
I reckon me and Max are just as good as that, yes.
Oh, look at him.
What a cutie.
He's not so cute, believe me.
And how long have you been preparing for this?
5 years, Simon.
Oh, wow. OK, well, good luck.
Good luck. Oh, he's so cute.
Come here. Max.
And it's cold, please.
It's fine.
What's his problem with me? Yeah, come here. What? I love
that it? Is he gone?
Max, look! What? Come on! Bring him back on.
There you are, there you are. Good boy. Are we friends? Are we friends? Are we friends now? Are we friends now? Are we friends? There we are, here we are. Come on, come on, come on. Good boy, good boy. Good boy. Oh. Good boy.
What's his problem? Come here.
Okay,
Max.
I can't write this.
Are you okay? Are you okay? You all right? Good. Go on.
I like the act. Dog has good instincts.
All right, thanks a lot.
Apart from chasing Ant, I just really would love to know what else Max was going to do.
He should have done some singing.
Seriously? Always wanted to find a dog that could sing.
It's just brilliant it all went to plan. I'm sorry, it's enough.
Thank you.
Well done, Max. Okay.
Tell me why you decided to enter Britain's Got Talent.
I've wanted to enter for a few years now, but I've always chickened out. but quite a lot has changed for me in the last year, so...
What's happened?
Go. Oh, fun things like moving house, getting divorced, you know, good things. Exciting, fun things.
What's the act you're going to do today?
I'm going to be doing some impressions.
Oh, yes. OK, well, good luck.
I'm so nervous, it's stupid.
Deep breath.
Deep breath.
Oh, hope nerves don't get the better of her.
I hope she's good.
To love about you. That was fantastic. Really witty acts.
We all loved you.
Yeah, we did.
Alicia.
Jess, this is one of the rare moments where we sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Oh, that was a stunning audition.
Thank
well
you
done.
So much. Thank Nailed
you.
It. Honestly, Jess, that was amazing. Really, really.
It is so hard to do what you've just done. The way that you combine the songs was great. You've conquered the nerves, gone through the divorce, but we'll vote. David?
I'm going to say yes.
I'm going to say yes.
Thank you. It's a yes from me.
OK, Jess, you know where this is going. Get ready. It's four yeses.
Welcome to Blackpool. One woof for yes, two woofs for no. Did Anton Deck get you a bone? Woof!
Well, look, the stage is yours.
Good luck.
Love it.
It's an Irish dancing dog. That's a good idea.
I've never had this before. Dudley!
Dudley, stop it!
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Palladium Theatre, I invite you to stand and welcome Her Majesty the Queen.
The Queen? What? That's why there's a throne.
That's right, Mr. Cowell. The boss is finally here. It's so good to see a member of the royal family sitting next to Simon. It's lovely to see you, Camilla. Yes. It is rare indeed for the sovereign to appear on such an insignificant occasion. But as I look down on you all, I am happy to patronize you. Queens have always patronized the arts, and the arts have relied upon the support of queens. And it is with regret, ladies and gentlemen, I have noted that recently Britain's Got Talent has suffered enormously. There have been far too many below-average variety acts. And I'm not referring to Alicia Dixon. I beg your pardon. I'm sure you all agree that plastic is the modern scourge on the face of this planet. Of all the men and women of these islands, no greater innovation has been made than by our judging panel, who have stored a great amount of plastic in their faces.
Oh, cutting!
That direction.
For their services to the entertainment industry, and Dick, as well as David Williams, have been awarded OBEs. Simon, there is only one thing standing between you and the knighthood, and that's the golden buzzer. I have much pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, in declaring the search for talent in Great Britain officially open.
Oh, Your Majesty, what a treat!
Simon? I'll be serious today. I'll do as Simon says. I'll put this hair and I introduce myself properly. My name is Viggo Venn. That means my mother is Norwegian and my dad is a diagram. I did stand up! I feel like we should get to know each other a bit closer.
Please. Yes!
Yeah? My name is Viggo.
My name is My name is
Viggo. Yeah. You want to try to?
No.
Okay.
Yes. My name is
My name is Viggo. You are Bruno, the new guy.
Yeah. Oh, I forgot.
The new guy.
Thank you for reminding me. Okay, I have to do all the work here. Are you ready?
Yes. I am ready again.
I start there, I come back to you.
Yes. Are you coming back? I promise.
My name is
Alicia!
My name is
Wow, so much attitude!
My name is Alicia! My name is
Wow!
My name is Alicia!
Wow, that's so good. Okay, Bruno. Someone was drinking before the show!
It's a man.
A little bit sexy.
Hello, darling. It's a man. Hello, darling. It's a man.
Enthusiastic judge in the world!
My name is
Cow.
My name is
Cow.
My name is...
I could do this all night. Cow. Can I just keep... Can I do it to just... Can I do it just one...
No.
My name is Matt Edwards.
Hi, Matt.
Hello.
Where are you from? Where are you from, Matt?
I'm from Suffolk.
Suffolk? Great.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
34. Do you have a day job?
Do I look young? I'm a magician, is what I do for my day job.
Lovely. So tell us something about you that makes you different from other magicians that we may have seen on the show.
I think what makes me different from other magicians is the type of magic I perform isn't necessarily sleight of hand. It's a little bit crazy, a little bit variety, I would say.
It's like the sound of that. All right, well, we look forward to your act. Good luck.
So I do it now?
Yeah.
It's lovely to meet you all. My name is Matt. What's your name? Brilliant, that's enough. Now, I've only got like a minute to show you what I can do, so ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to perform a trick. But before I do my trick, I'm going to propose a toast. I want to say cheers to everybody. So when I say cheers, everybody in the audience shouts...
Cheers!
Perfect, amazing. Now, because I've only got a minute, I'm going to give this a big build-up in the hope that everyone claps really loudly and then all the ladies take off their bras and throw them in my face. Looking at you, Alicia. Worth a try. So, ladies and gentlemen.
Señores y señores, bienvenidos a la Britain's Got Talent. Esta noche siempre para tequila. Rachel, I'm an Angie.
Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba.
Save Lee Evans and magic.
I like him.
I do.
Yeah. What's this? Might as well. I forgot the salt. Gotta have salt. Oh.
Tequila.
Forgot the salt. Hup. I'm fine, I'm fine. Sorry. You're a brew. A brew. Sorry. Sorry. Wait, no.
Tequila!
Ladies and gentlemen, everybody, cheers! Thank you.
Thanks.
David.
David.
Wow, what a brilliant way to present a magic trick.
It's good.
I love when people push jokes as far as they possibly can go until they almost break. It was very funny, very entertaining. It was brilliant. Well done.
Thank you. Amanda?
Yeah, I mean, I really loved it. It was sort of silly how Tommy Cooper used to do it. You know, you're so distracted by you clowning and messing about that we're not paying attention to what you're actually doing, so therefore it's even more magical. I really love you. I think you're charming, I think you're funny, and you're kind of old school with a twist, which is absolutely perfect for Britain's Got Talent. Well done.
Simon?
I've got to be honest with you, Matthew. You know, when you started with that voice, I thought this is going to be really annoying. But actually, you are brilliant. I mean, really, really funny. And how old are you, 34, did you say?
34.
Okay, I'm surprised you haven't had a break yet, Matthew, because you're really likeable and nuts. You've just got something about you, it's your energy. This is what we look for on these shows, people who've got star quality. I've just got a feeling about you.
Good, you know.
He's good. Really good.
I agree, Matthew. Love your passion and enthusiasm. Right, we're going to take a vote. David.
Oh, they've got the vote. I'm going to say yes.
Yeah, hold on,
you don't
hold,
have
hold,
to.
Hold on, hold on.
You don't
have to.
Hold on.
Excuse me. Hold on.
I wasn't expecting that.
Honestly, we were laughing so much, I thought I was going to pee myself. Really funny. Well deserved.
Honestly, we loved the act, and then Simon, you said it. He's 34 years old, and for some reason, he hasn't been given the break up until now. And so we just wanted to be there and do it.
Honestly, very good.
Well
done. Funny. Really good. Really good. Really good. Love it. Yes! That's a good one.
Yeah!
He picked a good one!
I like him.
I've got to tell you, Matt, they were absolutely on the money. This is what it's all about. Dreams come true. Good for you.
He deserves it, man. Look at that. Look at that.
Thank you so much.
Loved it.
Oh my
honestly.
God.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. I've been very well looked after.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Okay. And what's your name?
My name is Johnny Awesome.
Come on, Johnny.
Be awesome.
I'm 39. I'm from Derby, but I live in Croydon.
Okay. And are you married?
Yeah, I'm married and I've got two small children.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a full-time comedian, yeah.
So tell me, Johnny, what's missing? What has been missing?
I wanted to come and play on a big stage to a theatre full of people, and I'm here, and I'm very excited about doing it.
What is that break you need?
Well, I'll be totally honest. I need the chance to play to a big audience.
Yeah.
Such as Britain's Got Talent.
OK.
I'm really hoping this is going to go well, Johnny.
Thank you. Actually, just before I start, are Ant and Dec still there? Can you just pop out here for 1 second? Sorry. Ant, I'll just put you there. Just stand next to me. And Dec, if you just go there.
Yeah, sure.
I know this is crazy, but I just want to see if you can do something, right? You stay stood there. When I go down, guys, you stay there.
Yeah.
When I come back up again, I want to see if you guys can go down. So look, here we go.
Right.
I'm going down, and then I'm coming back up, and you're going down. Can we get a rhythm going? Is there a rhythm to that? Is there any rhythm? Oh, look at them go. Look at them go. Yes.
I like this.
Let me just ask you one quick question. Have you boys ever been to see a musical in the West End?
Yeah, yeah.
Which one did you see?
Oh, I've seen loads. Wicked.
Wicked? Yeah, it's a good one. What makes me laugh, though, is that when you go and see a musical, some guy will just start belting out a song.
Start belting out a song.
Apparently, it's not unusual. In fact, the band will start to play along, and then the music swells up, and the lights will change. This is a musical, and we're doing the dance. Thank God it's not Chicago, or we'd be in our pants. This is a musical. We're the talk of the town. Our choreographer has made us bob up and down. This is a musical featuring and Dec. Oh, boys, when you're starring in a musical, it's important that you can sing. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But guys, that ain't the only thing. No, no. You've got to dress up right.
Thanks.
For the opening night. And with a costume, you'll feel like a king. Looking good.
This is a musical.
And we're wearing our hats. Because this is a musical, we don't look like rats.
This is
a musical featuring Ant and Dec. Now, audience, double claps. Come on. Oh, look, no, even Simon Cowell is doing it. That's great. Oh, God, boys, oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, my God, put your arms around me. I think we're about to be part of a chorus line. Let's go that way.
This is everything.
This is a musical, and we're changing the key. I don't know why we did that now. It's too high for me. We'll do whatever. Our director goes out. We're all grinning like idiots. We're doing jazz hands. This is a musical.
Well done. Well done.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Orson.
Everything about it was really, really polished. The lyrics were brilliant, and you are the most likeable guy.
Thank you very much.
Johnny, that was brilliantly inventive. The amount of people we give, you know, 2 or 3 minutes on the show to, and, you know, you think, wow, is that it? Well, you went to town. I mean, we couldn't want for anything more.
Thank you very much.
Oh, well, thank you. Appreciate it.
You did a full-scale show for us. And you featured Ant and Dec, OBE.
Yes from us.
Yes from me.
It was absolutely brilliant.
Thank you.
Johnny, it was so smart. I think this whole kind of musical thing, singing, it really works for you because it makes you stand out.
Thank you, Simon.
I like you a lot. We're going to vote. David?
Well, obviously, I'm going to say yes!
Thank you, David.
I'm saying yes.
Thank you very much.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you.
Johnny Awesome, you deserve, and you've got, 4 yeses. Congratulations.
So much. Thank you, guys. Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Francine Lewis.
Francine Lewis.
Yes.
And do you have a day job, Francine?
Well, I'm a mum. I'm a mum of two, so I do my impressions to entertain everyone when I can.
It's impressions that you do?
Yes.
Best of luck.
Let's do it.
Oh my God! Oh my God! I'm like so nervous, so excited. It's like being on the X Factor all over again. Oh my God! I just love being a celebrity. When my agent said I was doing an advert for Iceland, I rushed out to get a woolly hat, a woolly coat, and a passport.
Hello, honeys. 100% definitely. You'll come to Amy Charles' salon in Essex. I love Essex. I work in Essex. I live in Essex. It's all about Essex. And I can spell Essex, I think. Oh, shut up.
Oh, well, there's only one pricey. As you know my private life, you'll know I've just got married. Again. I organised it all. The church, the honeymoon, and the divorce lawyer.
Hi, I'm Holly Willoughby.
In your face, Holly Willoughby!
And I present everything on ITV. And surprise, surprise, because tonight, Simon Cowell, I reunite you with the gorgeous Cheryl Cole. Hey. I'm totally, utterly excited to be here.
Oh, my God.
Even to see you, Simon. My frenemy. Thank you! Because I'm gonna, my eyelashes will fall off.
Wow.
Oh, that was so lovely.
That
Thank
was
you.
Incredible. Brilliant impressions, brilliant choices of people, all none of which I've seen before. Amazing to be funny and beautiful. I thought it was just me, but you are too.
I love you. Whatever happens in this competition, you are amazing at what you do. I'm speechless.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
When you started doing Stacey Sullivan, you didn't even have to speak. It was just the first noise I knew who it was.
Oh, my God.
It was, I know.
I love you.
Most of all, what I really admire about you is how you're not trying to sneak back into the door of show business. You've just stood on a stage of a show with millions of people watching, and you're just willing to give it a go to get back out there. And I'm backing you all the way, because it was amazing.
Simon.
Those impressions were fantastic. Normally, I don't know who half these people are. They were current, funny, the dialogue was good. And you look amazing, and you put everything together. I really do think we are looking at a future star.
Thank you.
OK, we've got to vote, first of all. David, yes or no?
It's a yes.
You've got four yeses for.
She's back, back, back!
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big-name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiancé... We've got a little boy called Roman, who's here as well. And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and...
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. OK, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Coach! I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, Kujo, come here. Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? Coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered, he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena. Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. Dad! Can't you get it yourself?
It was 1 p.m, but it got dark real quick.
The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes, I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows. 4! But there's only 1 person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long. Go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones, yeah? So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you, right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open? I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence.
Nice.
I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met. He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy. Like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride. You can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently. Me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter. The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5.
Very good.
My name's Kojo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Kojo, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'm so happy right now. I've always respected you. My respect level for you has just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny. Yeah. You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. But I love you.
I really get it.
I have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you. Enjoy this.
Dear 25, 8:48 a.m. and the new celebrity housemates have arrived by Big Brother Carl.
Ah,
Oh, did somebody mention cow? Oh, yeah. Oh, hello, Simon. Or can I call you Daddy?
8:49 a.m. The housemates are having donuts for breakfast.
Ah, did somebody mention donuts? Donuts. Mmm. Is there anything they can't do? Mmm.
Marge!
Oh, Homer, what are you talking about? Are you talking about donuts again, homie? Homie!
We'll be back after the break.
I've had an accident. And I think I'm entitled to some compensation.
9:49 a.m. Time to find out if he's got the X Factor.
You look like a pop star. You sound like a pop star. I'm putting you through. But Sharon, Nicole, we need to find out the thoughts of one final judge, Simon.
Okay, let me stop you there.
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name's Steve Royal.
Steve, where are you from?
I'm from Chorley in Lancashire.
Chorley. That'll be good, this guy.
Chorley cake.
And Steve, how old are you?
I'm 51.
51. Are you married?
I am married, yeah. The wife doesn't know I'm here.
Oh, I love that.
I didn't mention it all.
Do you have kids?
Three daughters. It's the reason I do stand-up. I've got four women in the house. It's the only chance I get to speak. Let's get a bit of atmosphere. I'm not messing about. Three of them straight away. Hey, hey, up, hey, 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 up, hey, hey, hey. Oh, I got sort of music. Stop. No, my fault. I forgot. There used to be two of us. First gag! I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll do a bit of balloon modelling. Alicia, can I ask you to name an animal? Give me a challenge. Go on, give me a challenge. Any animal.
Elephant.
I'm sorry. It's a lovely
Any other animal. I'll tell you what I'll do. I've seen this stuff on Britain's Got Talent before, this mind reading stuff. And I'm into that Derren Brown. He simply puts ideas into people's heads without them realising it. I'm going to make you think of a very specific animal now, Alicia. When you get a clear image of the animal that I'm sending to your brain, shout out the name of the animal so everyone can hear loud and clear, and woof, I'll make it as fast as that. So when you get a clear image of the animal, woof, woof, that's how fast. What? Just
dog,
say dog. I've only got 4 minutes.
Dog,
nine, four,
dog.
Balloon animal, dog. Hardest part of this is blowing the balloon up.
Look at his cheeks.
Get it. I'll do something else. Enjoy now the beautiful sound of the Spanish guitar. I've just got to get the guitar, which is situated just over here.
Para sido no volverá más. Y me hizo volar en el cielo infinito.
Yeah.
such a pleasure to be entertained by you.
Oh, thank you.
Because you're brilliantly funny. And sometimes we're not really judges anymore, we're just audience members.
Exactly.
We're just having a great time in the hands of a great entertainer. That's what you
thank
are.
You
you're
very
a
much
great
much.
Entertainer.
It means a lot. Thank you very, very much.
Alicia.
You're so likeable, so natural, a born performer. Just everything about that was fantastic. So for me, you're like the heart and soul of this show because you've just come out and made everyone smile
and
feel good.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
I mean, it was classic Britain's Got Talent. I absolutely adored this act. It was old school, but it felt fresh. It felt polished. I just sat back and went, oh yeah, this is just brilliant.
Thank you.
I think what you've done today is show us you're naturally funny. This was a good audition.
Great!
Yeah, very kind of like end of the pier British, which I like.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, let's start with you, David Walliams.
Oh, Steve, of course. It's a yes!
Thank you.
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me, Steve.
Got four yeses.
I will. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Do I just start then?
To start.
Do you think it would be any good?
No.
Hello! My name's Graham and it's now time for some magic. And for my magic tonight, I'm going to need a glamorous assistant. Amanda, could you join me on the stage? Let's have a big cheer for Amanda, everybody!
Woo! That big enough for you?
Now, what we're going to do tonight is me and Amanda are going to do some magic. First of all, I'm going to start with a simple magic trick. So I've got some cards here tonight. I've got a birthday card. I've got a wedding card. I've got a get well soon card. I've got welcome to your new home and happy birthday, generic pink. So I'm going to place the cards face down because that's what all the magicians do. What one do you want to go for, Amanda?
This one.
That one. Have a look, Amanda. Lovely. And I will now predict what card Amanda has picked. Amanda?
Yeah?
I've forgotten what one it was. Now... now, Amanda, I've written a word on the piece of paper just here. Do you know what the word says?
No.
No, that's correct. No. And now I have two cups at the bottom of the water. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. There's water going in that one. I'm going to tip water in that cup like that. A little bit more in that one, a little bit more in that one. And now, before your very eyes, me and Magic Amanda will make the water disappear. Amanda, if you put the cup on your head like that, Amanda, could you hold that with one hand for me? Trust me, Amanda, I am a magician. So we're going to do the magic water dance. And ladies and gentlemen, the magic water dance will make the water disappear. Let's do this, yeah! Right. Okay, I'll do the dance first. You go right foot, left foot, you turn around, you face the back, you bend your knees three times, and then you wiggle your bottom three times. Yeah, now make the water disappear. Your turn, off you go. Right foot, left foot, left foot. Turn around, face the back, three knee bends, three bottom wiggles. Give her a big cheer, everybody. The water dance has made the water disappear. Do you cut feel lighter, Amanda?
No.
That's a problem. I'll go first. Here we go. Three, two, one. Yeah! Amanda, trust the magic. I promise you, if you trust the magic and believe in the magic, you will not get wet. Slowly turn it over. Do you want me to sip it over for you? Go, Amanda. Trust the magic, Amanda. Three, two, one. That is magic. Ladies and gentlemen, big cheer for Amanda. Wow, you're amazing, Amanda. I don't feel quite so nervous now. Honestly, you've made me happy today. My mum would be ashamed if she knew I was here today. She thinks I'm in prison.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Uexa Kazuhisa.
And why are you here on Britain's Got Talent?
ここにビッグチャンスがあると思ったからです。
Because there's a big chance you give me.
What? What? Oh, we're going to give you a big chance. We are.
Right.
Have you seen the show before?
Of course.
And so, is this your day job, what you're going to do for us today?
International variety performance.
You're an international variety performer, okay.
And what is your day job?
He's an international variety performer. Unless his job has changed in the last few seconds, I'd say it's still international variety performer. The stage is yours.
That the winner of this show gets to perform in front of the royal family?
Of course.
It was highly erotic.
Thank you. You would understand me, I thought.
We're always looking for something different on the show. And we've never seen an act quite like you before. So, arigato gozaimasu.
Arigato gozaimasu.
Yes.
Let me kick this off with a note.
More! More! Simon, please. More. It's a yes from me.
Oh, it's a yes from me.
Hang on a second. Let's give this a drum roll.
I wonder what I'm going to say.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Todju.
And how old are you?
40.
And are you married?
Is that a proposal? No, not married. Not to my knowledge.
And what is it that you're doing for us today?
Stand-up, impressions.
Brilliant.
We'll wish you all the best.
Yes.
Thank you. I love TV, man. Anybody here remember Blind Date?
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's Blind Date!
And here's your host,
Missilla Black!
Oh. Oh. We've got three bonny lads behind that screen.
I didn't expect them to do Missilla. I really didn't.
And here's the gorgeous girl who's gonna meet him. Her name's Amanda. Come in, Amanda.
You know, I'd love to have seen. The screen goes back. She doesn't like the look of the guy. She makes it clear. Du-du-du-du-du-du-du. Pretty women, why do you always come to the club with a friend that doesn't look as cute as you? Yes, and guys, just as you're about to get the cute one's number, the friend comes along and messes it up completely. Yes, let me set the scene, Alicia. Hi, you're kind of cute. Oh, you're cute too. Here comes the friend. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Then they turn to their friend. Who is he? Who is he? Who is he? Then they turn back to you. Are you a nutter? You look like a nutter. You act like a nutter. Can you prove you're not a nutter? Exactly what I thought. You are a nutter. If I'm not getting a man, no one's getting a man. Total Recall, Predator, Commando, action films. I love them. Favorite action hero? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yes. Because Schwarzenegger is always asking questions.
What the hell is going on? What did I do wrong?
And he's always trying to explain his drama to other people that don't care.
Some men just tried to kill me. I think they were spies or something. Harry from work, he was the boss. Blood on my shirt, blood on my hands, blood on my knife. He tried to take my life. Get down!
Thank you.
He's funny!
I like it. I really like it.
I do like it, it's funny. Wait there a second, we've got something we've got to do.
Oh my God!
Together? Yeah! Stay close to me.
That really moved me. I mean, Anton Dex, thank you so much, boy.
He's good. He's very good. He's good.
Congratulations.
Hello, my love. What's your name, please?
My name is Frederick Bowers.
Would you mind if I asked how old you were?
I'm 73.
That you're going to do for us today?
I'm going to do break dancing.
Break dancing?
What's he going to break?
How long have you been break dancing?
5 years.
Okay.
I taught myself.
You taught. What would it mean to you to perform in front of the Queen at the Royal Variety Show?
I would be honoured to show her what I can do.
Good for you, Fred. Well, whenever you're ready.
Come on, Fred!
Doing this show because of people like you, Fred. Absolutely brilliant.
You were digging it, bro. I mean, you were.
This show is about spirit and variety and energy and about soul, and you've got plenty of it.
Thank you.
It's a yes from me, Fred.
Amanda?
Yes, definitely.
Fred Bowers? Yeses.
Yes, Fred.
So, Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son. He's in the audience.
Nice.
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
Come, we're friends now.
Yeah, OK, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job. This is obviously what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%. It's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going.
Yeah.
So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was going to drive here today. I realised I don't have a licence, so... Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? Think... No, you don't. This old lady's strong. Oh my... have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a minus 2 at King's Cross, love. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. Well, on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know?
Aww.
Yeah, so we went to give her a fitting name, so we named her Faiza, yeah? Yeah, I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good.
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I I do, when I use it, beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That'll be £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiance have been together for years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humor. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's the trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She'd come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know what time you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at this time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face, get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face. But how do I do it? In style.
Yay! In style!
My name's Axel Blake, thank you.
What did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that stage. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You got a wonderful, so likable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this.
What's your name?
My name's Dante.
Oh, I love that name. How old are you, Dante?
13 years old.
Are you supposed to be at school this minute?
Yes, I am, but...
However...
Yeah,
do welcome. They know why?
Not really, no.
Oh, okay.
We'll keep it a secret.
And what is the reason that you decided to come on Britain's Got Talent?
So I was born with brittle bone disease. And I've came on Britain's Got Talent to show other people like myself that even if you've got some sort of disability or disadvantage, that you can go as far as your imagination wants to take you.
How would you spend the money if you won Britain's Got Talent?
I would buy my mum a giant house.
Aww. Is that who's in the wings, your mum?
Yes, I wouldn't go anywhere without her.
Well, the stage is yours. Good luck.
Thank you.
I am just 13 years old. I've broken 97 bones. The hospital's my second home. But I just wanna say, don't feel sorry for me, 'cause I feel sorry for you. I get to go on the rides in Disneyland while you're stood in the queue.
That's brilliant.
Very good.
God, why did I get it?
Me and Dante know each other.
Oh, do you?
We've met a few times. Because he said, could you write a book about a boy in a wheelchair? And I dedicated it to Dante.
Is that why you didn't insult him?
You write that song yourself?
Yes, in lockdown.
It really captured you, how cheeky you are, how special you are, and how much you do to inspire others too. So I loved it, Dante.
Thank you, that means so much. Yeah, you're amazing. Very, very cheeky. Your laugh is really naughty as well, isn't it? What is there not to love about you? Well done, Dante. Thank you.
Comedy often has to make you think or make you go, oh, God, are we allowed to say that? And that's when it's the best comedy. So that was a really funny song. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, it was just a great audition. And if we put you through to the next round, can I help you write the lyric? About someone on this panel?
We'll have to wait and see.
I always say a great audition is one you're going to remember, and I'm going to remember this. It was great. Can I be the first to say yes, please?
It's a yes from me, Dante.
I'm saying yes, Dante.
And it's a yes from me, so that's four yeses. Well done.
What's your name, please?
Noel. Noel James.
How old are you, Noel, if you don't mind me asking?
52.
What do you do, Noel?
I invigilate in schools.
What's that?
When the kids are doing exams in schools and you sort of look after them, you know, make sure they don't cheat and stuff.
Yeah.
If you'd have taken any O-levels or A-levels, Simon, you'd know that.
Are you with anyone today?
Unfortunately, my girlfriend couldn't make it because she doesn't exist.
Well, look, good luck.
Thank you very much. Good evening, Blackpool. My name is Noel. My full name is, in fact, Noel Wynne James. That's right, I don't pronounce the in fact. And I'm glad you're laughing, because I've had a terrible day. You've cheered me up. Do you know, I was woken up at 4 a.m. this morning. The phone rang. I thought, who's ringing me at this time? I picked the phone up. Achoo! Down the line. Achoo! It was a cold caller at that time.
Very good. Very good.
But as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, I brought my instrument with me tonight. I do hope you enjoy this next tune. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now, this is... sorry, I just bring the guitar to keep it in shape, you see. I don't know if you've seen one of these before. This is an old Welsh instrument. It's got a Welsh name, that's right. It's called a bag. And I am going to play a tune for you, ladies and gentlemen. This is not an original tune. This is a cover.
He's good, isn't he? We like Noel.
And some of you may recognize it. Here we go. Yadent. Yadent. It's a famous film from the 70s. It's The Elephant Man. You up for some music, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah!
So, ba-ba, black sheep. Of any wool. Yes, sir, yes, sir. Lord, I got 3 bags full. I said, ba! Sheep solo, ba! That's 12 bar blues.
Hello.
How are you, David? How are you, love?
How are you?
I'm all right, thanks.
Please tell us your name.
Barbara Nice. Barbara's in Streisand, Nice is in the biscuit, Dave.
Oh. They are nice, those biscuits, aren't they?
They are, love.
And is this your day job, or...?
Well, I jig all over the country, and I just like people making fun of life and having a laugh.
Excuse me, you look familiar. Have we met?
I don't think...
OK, I was thinking... Whether you come on the show before?
No, I've never been on
never.
A competition.
This is your first time.
I've never done a competition
wow.
before.
Okay,
love.
Good for you. Yeah.
Lovely teeth, by the way. I just thought, yeah, I just thought it's about time. And if I could go to the Royal Variety performance, that's a dream come true for me.
All right, good luck.
Thanks, love. Right, so I'm going to put my bag for life down. I've got about 49 bags for life. I should never die. But who wants to live forever? Not me, I've got no proper pension. Right, I'm going to take my coat off. I can see the girls, Amanda and Alicia. Nice colour, isn't it, this Mac? It's like an apple green, girls. It's me Apple Mac, ladies and gentlemen. Hey. She's living the vida loca. Hey, come on. Diamonds are forever. Keep your eye on it, love. You look like you keep a good house. So, $4.99. I like a bargain, like I see a lot of you do. So this frock, forget DKNY. This frock was CPL, Cats Protection League. If my husband Ken could see me now, you know, here, auditioning BGT, he'd go mad. He thinks I'm dog sitting for Jean and Jean in Ebden Bridge, so keep it. Mum's the word. You're friendly. That's what I like. I bumped into a very, very good old friend of mine, Unlucky Mary. Come in here. She said, Barbara, I'm in trouble with police. I thought, what's new? I said, well, what's been going on? She said, I've been caught speeding while knitting. I know. Apparently, the police said, pull over. She said, no, cardigan. We're living a visa loca. We've got to have a laugh, kids. It's all we've got left.
I love her.
I love her.
And this has cheered me up, this has. I was outside having a bit of fresh air, and I got a text. I'm very sorry, Barbara. Your boiler's broken down. It's awful news, isn't it? And I thought, I'm not going doing that audition. I've got to get the bus, go back home, cos Ken will go to pieces. It's a crisis. But, you know, in life, do you ever think there's signs?
Yeah.
Yeah, right, smashing. There are signs in life. And I looked up at this tree, and there was a white carrier bag caught in the branches. And I looked up and I thought, that's 5p up there, Barbara. And then suddenly, there was a gust of wind, and that carrier bag blew high up, free as a bird. And I thought, forget about the pig in boiler, Barbara. Let it go. That's the cue for the stage dive. So those lads come down here. Give them a round of applause. I met them in the queue. Down here, kid.
My name is Robert.
How old are you, Robert?
I just turned 30 11 years ago. So.
Is this your job, or do you have a normal job?
I teach tiny little primary school children music as well, so I do that, which is nice.
Okay, best of luck.
Right, so basically, I've written a song specifically for you, which makes me nervous, and also I'm slightly nervous because I've got something called dyslexia, which was very good for music, because when I was young I taught myself the piano, although it's not so good as I'm older. I recently tried to book tickets for Rihanna, and I booked tickets for Ryanair. thank you.
Very good.
I've got something called Asperger syndrome, which means I'm a genius. No, it's nice to be here. I've had a bit of a rough week. I've actually moved into a flat with my boyfriend. Yes, boyfriend, gay. and autistic, two ways I can't think straight. Thank you. And,
That is a good one.
So, I usually, when I do clubs, I swear a lot. So, I've got to be PC. I've done a song which is literally PC, because it's about computers. And I have done it three times, and each time people have laughed, so if you don't, you're wrong. Here we go. Here we go. Thank you. George Formby, working in a computer shop. I work in the computer shop, make a computer bright and clean. So much crumbs and vomit, and don't ask what's on the screen. I do half the work, charge double the time. You wouldn't want a job like mine if you would find the things I'd find when I'm cleaning Microsoft Windows. David Walliams wanted to update his content reminder. He brought me a massive ring binder. But when I looked, all the contacts were from Grindr. Cleaning rugs up windows. Alicia Dixon's webcam was another case. She said the picture was awful, but actually it was just her face. It was too lovely, her face was too lovely. There you go. Amanda Holden was the only one whose Instagram was on the mark. She said her outfits have so much spark. I said, I'm just jealous I'll never dress like you because I don't shop in Primark.
I'm okay with that.
Cleaning Microsoft Windows. Simon Cowell's Facebook was around the bend. He brought it to me to try to mend. It wasn't broken. He's just got no friends. cleaning rugs off windows.
Oh, Robert, I love you.
Wow.
I mean, everything you said was hilarious. You're just a beautiful soul. Comedy flows from you like water. I love that you had a go at us all. I think some people were more hurt than others. Some was just entirely truthful. but I just can't wait to see what you're going to do next.
Wow.
From start to finish, that was hilariously funny. You're a shining star. It's fantastic.
You're very self-deprecating, and I think that you have funny bones, and your audition was fabulous.
Thank you.
Really good.
Look, Robert, you know what? You're very unique, you're very quirky, very funny, very naughty. Robert. Which we like.
Thank you.
Thank you. David, yes or no?
It's a big fat yes!
Wow.
I'm saying yes.
I'm saying yes.
Robert White, you got four yeses. Congratulations.
Lovely man.
No, sir.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, what's your name, please?
My name's Lorraine Bowen.
Great. Do you have a normal job, Lorraine?
I do teach the piano to 12 students.
Obviously, you're singing for us. Are you singing one of your own songs?
Yes, it's called The Crumble Song.
The Crumble?
Yeah, Crumble, yeah, as in Sunday
Apple.
Afternoon pudding, yeah.
And Lorraine, can I ask you a question? Who are you here with?
I'm here with just me, Cassia Organ. It's just... That's it.
OK, good luck.
Great, let's go.
Everybody's good at cooking something. I'm good at cooking crumble. In fact, I've got one in the oven. Would you like some? A bit of custard, a bit of cream. It reminds you of your best dream. Anything you want with it, anything you want. But if you don't tell me soon, Off on my bike. Everybody's good at cooking something, and I'm good at cooking crumble. In fact, I've got one in the oven. Would you like some? Well, would you like some, right?
Yes! I'd like some.
Hey, let's just get this party really going now. My bingo wings are out there. I'll tell you what. Let's do a mashup. Look, I've got my DJ headphones. You get it? Flashing lights, come on, flashing lights. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Everybody's good at cooking something. But I'm good at cooking crumble. Everybody's good at cooking something.
It doesn't matter what these things. your consignment. Listen to them. Listen to them. Oh, you've done it again. Yeah.
Bye.
What is your problem? I don't have a problem. She was very entertaining. That is a catchy song.
Hello, my love. Who are you?
My name's Siobhan, Siobhan Phillips. Mm-hmm. I am 42. I know I don't look it. And I'm from Wakefield.
Yorkshire. And Siobhan, what is the big dream?
I've been a performer for a long time and I feel like I would love it if I had a venue where people have paid to come and see me. Do you know what I mean?
I do know what you mean.
That'd be great.
OK, good luck.
Come on, girl.
So I don't know if you've noticed, but there's a piano forte behind me. And I'm going to sit down. I'll get further away, but you'll still be able to see me. What I've done, I've written a song, because a couple of years ago, I became a mum for the first time. I thought to myself, what I'll do, I'll wait till I'm 40, I'm really old and tired, and then I'll have a baby. So I wrote a song because they always say you should write songs about subjects with which you are familiar, but I couldn't think of a melody around cake. So I've put a little song together, and I hope you like it. You can join in, but you won't know it because I've written it. So.
What did I do? I haven't slept since I look 102. I've piled on weight, they say, when is it due? I answer through gritted teeth, she's just turned two. I stand plastic dinosaurs every single day. I dream of killing Peppa Pig in a brutal way. And I would strangle Mr. Tumble with his spotted back. And if it wasn't for Prosecco, I'd probably go mad.
Yeah!
Kids, 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 oh what fun. I sometimes wish that I'd become a gun. Then she smiles at me, and I do it all again. But I think I'd skip the toddler years and push her out at 10. Push her out at 10, and then sleep again. I hate my life. Going to the loo alone would be a special treat.
Right? Yes.
I'd love to read my Kindle when I'm lying on the beach. I need to join the gym again, it pains me to admit. I accidentally put my bra on backwards and it fits. If I hear the question why again, I think I might just scream. But at least she's far too young to discuss the Brexit deal. And I only hope what's best for her to have a happy life.